it made out of some old boards that we had left over. And they just came FedEx. So we're getting ready to get them planted in the ground. This is what our bed has in it. This is the soil that we grew those fantastic peas in last year. It's 1/3 compost, 1/3 rotted manure, and 1/3 black dirt. And we've got it really well mixed together, and it's been in the ground for a year. This is leftovers from the bed, and we're using that to put in our holes of our fruit trees. Well, I've got the strawberry plants, and they're in the bucket. And as you can see, strawberries have long roots, and they make them hard to plant because you've got to get the roots nice and deep in the ground. But you don't want roots sticking out of the ground at all. You want it covered right to the very top, below where it starts growing out, but above the root. So we're going to dig a nice deep hole that we can lay the roots down. We don't want to cheat and make a little hole and bend the roots up because it won't grow well. We don't want to do this because it won't grow well. It wants to be nice and deep and the roots laid in there real nice. So we're going to start planting here. Garden is kind of coming along. We've got the onions planted. We've got 52 tomatoes and walls of water and a couple dozen peppers. The rhubarb is getting really big, and I'll be able to make some pies and can some rhubarb jelly and jam. And then we've got our new goat pasture. We've got about 3 acres of goat pasture all fenced here. And this is our second day with our little goat herd out on pasture, and boy are they enjoying it. But goats hate rain, and sometimes we can't get them in the barn quick enough, so Will is busily building them their summer goat cottage. Got a 10 by 12 foot little goat cottage on skids, and that way we can move it if we need to. Oh, we got the building inspector here. Will, do you think your building's gonna pass code?
I think so.
Maybe you'll have to give him a little bribe. What do you think?
I don't know. I got maybe a little bit of grain I can give him.
I think maybe you just passed.
Alright.
Our milker dough, our special milker that provides our house milk, is just getting ready to have kids. Look at that udder. Last year she was doing so good. We're having to give her extra feed because she's putting it all into her bag and her kids. She looks like she's going to have like 6. In the next day or two, we'll find out. We're checking out the orchard. And these are our free-range orchard chickens. They can't be exactly free-range because they get into my flower beds and then they get into my garden. But we fenced in the whole orchard, and they've got all this lovely clover. And so they eat the clover, scratch the dirt, eat the bugs, and we're just checking it out. One thing that we noticed is that the spots that didn't get any manure sure show the yellow and short stunted growth. This little apple tree is deader than a doornail. Why is it dead? Because Jackie didn't put any screen around it, and as you can see, the voles ate all the bark off of it during the winter time. And Jackie knows better, but because it had so many forks on it so low to the ground, I thought, oh, just one winter, they won't get it. Isn't it terrible when you know better and still don't listen to the inner voice?